all news, all the time. Now, back to Road Dog Trucking News with Mark Willis.
Drivers hate coast to coast and border to border. Let me give you the phone number to call into the program. It is 888-876-2336 all across North America. You know, one of the best things about working in trucking radio, ladies and gentlemen, is working with people. You know, I can go out and cover pretty much any story when you think about what's going on out there in the general media, from shootings and fires and plane crashes and things like that. You know, it's all about headlines and things like that. But this job gives me the opportunity to talk to some of the hardest working men and women in America. I'm talking about the truck driver out there, guys, the backbone of the American economy. If we did not have the trucking industry and truck drivers, man, think of where we wouldn't be. You think about what we need, and man, certainly we would be in a world of hurt if we didn't have the trucking industry to help back us up. And I want to showcase a little bit more about what's going on with the drivers. Terry Weston is with me, and he's been driving for 28 years, and he has just now hit the 2 million mile accident-free mark in intermodal. And also Christopher Daisy is with me as well, and he served in the United States Marine Corps. Thank you for your service. And, gentlemen, it's good to have you both on the program to talk about this. You are live across North America, no pressure. So a lot of fun. It's going to be great to chat with you. Terry, I want to talk to you to get started here. First off, I know that you are from Los Angeles. I know that you do drive intermodal in Los Angeles. And, man, that's a big job in itself, isn't it?
It's a job. It's something you have to get used to. It took a couple of years to get used to as I As I transferred out there to the big place. Okay. I left a 2-lane freeway to go to 7-lane and learned it. I've got it down to a science now.
Oh, it is a science, isn't it?
It's a science.
You know, when you think about it, because you got to navigate through the complexities of traffic, and you got to deal with you know, different things like road rage. That doesn't go on in Los Angeles, does it?
Well, it does, but, you know, we're immune to it after a while.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You do develop a sense of safety, and you look around, you're always making sure that everything is good. And, you know, Christopher Daisy, I'm sure you run into the same thing as well, that, man, your experience getting out there on the road, you got to stay focused. Last driver that was on talked about the, you know, the Smith system and what it means. So what do you do to be safe out there?
Well, when I was driving, basically it was always a thought process before getting in the vehicle, and it was to be safe in everything you do, not just in the truck while driving, but even getting outside of the truck, walking around the truck. There was a lot more to it. It was a whole entire lifestyle, an experience of applying that to everything you do. You almost have to think about it as being proactive instead of reactive.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You keep yourself out of the situations created by others by staying away from the packs of people, and it makes you safer automatically because you're not a part of all the mistakes other people make.
No, no, absolutely. And Terry, I've got to imagine that, you know, you do the same thing. You almost develop like a, it's almost like a sixth sense, if you will. You kind of expect the unexpected.
Oh, yeah, a sixth and a seventh sense, to be exact. Just focus. If you lose your focus, then you'll lose your way. So we stay focused at all times, especially when behind the wheel.
How important is the training that you get at J.B. Hunt? I know they've got specifics that they tell their drivers out there. Talk about how critical and how essential that is for your safety.
It's essential in our everyday operations. Safety comes first, and they taught it to us. They taught it to us well. They brought it to us. We learned it. We lived it, and here we are today, 27 years later, and here to say that we're safe.
Did you ever think you'd hit the 2 million mile mark?
I never paid attention. I just drove, and they brought it to my attention, and I never knew. I never counted. It just came to me.
No, that's great. I bet family, probably relatives, are extremely proud, right?
They can't believe it either. You know, small town guy doing something like this is amazing for me and my family.
Yeah, absolutely. And same thing for you, Christopher. I've got to imagine that, man, once you hit that 2 million mile mark, it was like, oh, that's pretty darn cool, right?
That was it for me. I got out of the truck after that. Seriously. Now I'm an operations safety supervisor.
Yeah.
So now I get to preach it from another standpoint, which would be to managers as well.
You know,
everyone has to be on that same process.
That's got to be a great process when you think about, you know, the fact that you made a decision to transition, say, from behind the wheel to getting into the operational standpoint. Mm-hmm. I do want to talk a little bit about that. I've got a break here for a news update and for traffic and weather. And ladies and gentlemen, if you want to get on board, I'd love to get you into the Mix at 888-876-2336. There's an interesting story I want Terry and Christopher to share when we come back out of the break concerning their vehicles. So we're going to take you back in time to find out what that story is all about. And again, if you are just now tuning into the program, man, I am honored to be at the J.B. Hunt 2018 Million Mile Driver Celebration. There are hundreds of people that are here talking with the drivers, you know, congratulating them for the great work that they have done. It was a great pleasure to talk with Mrs. J.B. Hunt, who was on the program earlier. She was the keynote speaker at a luncheon for the drivers. And, man, she shared some great stories about, you know, how the company has grown, where it's going from here. And I'll reiterate some of that as well. So, again, if you want to jump in, love to get you into the mix. You know the phone number. It is 888-876-2336. I got a break for a few minutes. Stay with me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Mark Willis, live across North America.
All news, all the time. Sirius XM Road Dog Trucking News is on the air. If you're talking about it, we're talking about it. Call Mark Willis now at 888-876-2336. Weigh in on the top news stories. Road Dog Trucking News starts right now.
Drivers, it is hour number two, Sirius XM's Road Dog Trucking News, live across North America. Thank you for being out there wherever you may be listening to me across North America. Let me give you the phone number to call into the show. It is 888-876-2336 or 8888 Road Dog. That's going to get you in. If you want to find me up on social media, you can do that as well. It's all news all the time. Sirius XM's Road Dog Trucking News, and it is up on Facebook. And if you're just now tuning into the program, you're late. No, I'm just kidding. It's good to have you on board, but just let me tell you where we are. We're broadcasting live from J.B. Hunt's World Headquarters in the beautiful city of Fayetteville, Arkansas, and I am here to see what's going on with the J.B. Hunt 2018 Million Mile Driver Celebration, and there are a number of drivers that are receiving their 2 Million Mile Awards, 3 Million Mile Awards out there, drivers. It's incredible when you think about all of the skill that it takes in order to operate a truck out there in all kinds of road and weather conditions. And this is about the driver today. Started out with the Wall of Fame, started out with the Hall of Fame walk, the walk down a flight of stairs, ladies and gentlemen, where there were dozens of drivers that were receiving their awards, coming down the stairs, having the entire staff give them a thunderous round of applause as they came down those stairs, getting high fives. Family here as well, very proud. And I've got two of those drivers in front of me right now. I'm talking with Terry Weston. He's been driving for 28 years. He is a 2 million mile winner. He's out of the LA area, drives intermodal. And also Christopher Daisy is with me as well. He went to a trucking school in Detroit to acquire a CDL, and then an uncle sent him on to J.B. Hunt, and which led him to apply back in 1992. He was initially based out of Springfield, Ohio. And, gentlemen, I want to congratulate the both of you for an incredible accomplishment. Thank you for the service, and thank you for being out there on the road today. And we've said it many times on the program and in the industry, man, if we didn't have you guys, we would not have trucking, right? So congrats to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. I want to talk about the story that was told to me about you two guys and your vehicles out there. Let's talk about that. Kind of set this up for us. How many years ago was this? What is that story about?
It was 19. Sorry, I didn't know I was going to go
That's
first.
All right.
It was 1992, and we both kind of ended up out in Southgate, California. Didn't even know each other. And we kept running each other into the driver lounge at the terminal, and I go, "You're always in here." And he said, "Well, so are you." And we started realizing we were both kind of homeless, sleeping in our vehicles in the parking lot, because could kind of get away with that because of the over-road division. So we were parked out there. I had the advantage, though, because he had a Z24 with a seat that went back. I had a van with a bed. So in the winter times, I'd hear him knocking, but I'm saying, no, you can't come in here. That was pretty much how it all came. That's when we became friends, because we were both in a little bit of misery together, but we just hung on with J.B. Hunt, and eventually, I think it was 3 months we lived like that?
Yeah, it was about 3 months. You know, you got to, back then trucking was different. You know, you start a little slow, and that's what we did. And after 3 months, we got it together, and we was able to actually get a roof over our head, but it took 3 months to live in a parking lot. I had a good neighbor.
That's great. No, that's a great story. You know, when it goes to show you that once you got situated, you know, you were able to build successful careers and go forward out there. Talk about the growth opportunities, you know, from when you two met. I'm sure you shared stories along the way as you developed in your careers and things like that, right? I mean, talk about from where you've been to where you are now.
Well, we started out young and, like I said, out in the parking lot, and we just worked our way in. We stayed with the program. Whatever J.B. Hunt had us do, we did it. I don't think we really realized what we were getting ourselves into, but, you know, we stayed with it, and it just worked out for us, and it hasn't been a problem.
Well, yours had a little bit of a coolness to it. See, I chased a girl from Detroit to California, and it didn't last. So 10 days later, I was homeless. That's how I started. So I had to do something to get a roof over my head. So
so there's a young lady involved somewhere.
Yeah, well, it didn't work out. But
no, I understand.
So the thing you think about is we had laundry facilities, TV, all that stuff at the terminal. So we were able to get by in that regard. And after that point, we ended up, because his family ended up ending out in California. Mine was in Detroit. I spent many holidays with his family year in and year out.
Yeah. How cool is
that? He actually helped me move from California to Central PA, but in a two-day ride. He drove, I slept, he drove, but yeah, he was basically all along, friends helped me out.
He's your best friend.
Well, I mean, I wouldn't say that. Look at him. he's a great guy.
We're family. Like I said, we've been. He knows. He's the growth of my kids. He watched them grow up.
Yeah,
they know him. Mm-hmm. I mean, we spent a lot of time in Southgate together. 25 years working day in
day. Yeah, day in and day out. You had the ups and downs of life. I mean, you shared probably family events.
Oh yeah.
Things that were going on.
But it's just been mostly good. You know, when you work, we have a good crew in Southgate.
Yeah.
Upstairs, so we were more. All of us were family. We all grew up together, and it's worked out. We were fortunate to be in Southgate.
Now, are you going to continue to drive, or what are you going to do?
Until they kick me out. I like where I am.
I like
Southgate. They give me the opportunity right now to mentor the younger guys that come in.
And sure, that means a lot. Absolutely.
When they come in, I tell them, you know, I want you to be like I am in 25 years. I want you to come here, stay.
Be successful.
Because J.B. Hunt gives you every tool to be successful. It's up to you to be there.
Yeah, absolutely. And Christopher, speaking of tools, I mean, now you're in a part of the company that deals with operations.
Yes.
So you made the transition. Talk about that. What do you do now?
Well, it's Operations Safety Supervisor for the Northeast region.
Okay.
And basically,
it's a big job, man.
It's pretty cool, but it's very high pressure in reference to, you think of a lot of people, especially the truck drivers, think I'm the enemy and I'm going to just try to bust them on something they did wrong. But it's really to get you to pause and think about what you're doing and to talk to even managers to speak the same language, because if everybody's on the same page, that will be the culture at hand. So I believe with my 2 million mile safe driving, my experience watching this company go from an over-the-road company all the way into this intermodal boom, I have the knowledge to talk to drivers so much about with the drivers rather than at the drivers about ways to be safer.
Mm-hmm.
And especially the newer people that you want to have trained properly, I can pick better trainers that I believe fit the bill. So it's something that perpetuates from here on based on them entrusting me to carry on the torch, if you will.
And carrying on that torch means you've got to have the resources and the tools in order to do that. And talk about that structure here at J.B. Hunt. They provide you with the ingredients you need. Then you take that. Then you communicate with those that are out there in the field, right? Talk about the platforms you have.
It's, okay, the Smith system is one, but also good leadership. You're allowed to be creative
to how you
apply and approach the way you want to talk to drivers, because everybody's different. You can't sit there in black and white trucking.
Right.
I know there's a million truck drivers out there, and they'll say, hey, man, it's not how it always goes. You have to realize there's variables. But it's, again, what I said earlier, the proactive sense of things where you prepare yourself. And if you have someone like myself who's been there, I can sympathize or empathize with what has to be done to make these things safer. So when new equipment is introduced, you don't just go, hey, this is how it works, this is what you do. You introduce to them how it works, how to understand the way it benefits you to make you an even better driver.
That technology really can make quite a difference out there from your standpoint, right? Because, you know, you're looking at technology that's helping you stay safe and helping you do. It's not there to replace you, but to help supplement what you do.
And it changes quite often. You know, new technology comes, and we have to go with it. J.B. Hunt has always brought it to us. We brought it in, and it works. You just have to adjust to the times, the new times.
All right, gentlemen, it is great to chat with you both. And I want to thank you for joining me on the program. Any closing thoughts, any advice, recommendations that maybe you can give to the new drivers about being safe? What would you tell them?
It starts with safety. If you don't put safety first, then it's going to be a rough road. Safety comes first, and it's safety, your family, and then yourself, and everything else just falls into place.
Absolutely. And what would you say to that, Christopher?
I'd say come on over to JB Hunt. We have everything you need to make you the best successful driver there is. I can tell you that right now.
Outstanding, gentlemen. Thank you for joining me on a program. Let's give these drivers, ladies and gentlemen, Terry Weston and Christopher Daisy, a great round of applause for talking about their experiences out there. And again, gentlemen, congratulations. 2 million. Congratulations.